Hey everyone, I guess we had a couple questions about barking in a car. Once again, it's lots of answers. There could be lots of answers for this. Quick. What does the car represent? Does the car, every time we get in the car, are we always going to some place that's supercharged? We're going to the dog park, we're going to the mountains, right? If we're charging the car with energy, right, that right there is going to contribute to the reactivity of being trapped in the car. That's most likely, if there's barking in the car, usually I would say that's probably where it's coming from. It could be happy reactivity, meaning like, yay, we're at a place, I get to get out, I'm, you know, or we're at a gas station that reminds me of a place that I've been to, so yay, I'm going to react. If it's territorial aggression, meaning the animal's like trying to keep everybody away from the car, that's something completely different. And you could even just start off with the very basic, is just change the pattern. Change the pattern, put the dog in a crate. Cover the crate. That doesn't mean you're getting rid of the problem, but at least what you're doing now is at least you're allowing the dog to have some experience riding in the car without exploding. Because that's what the dog needs. Not to be told right now to not do something, but basically that it can go into a crate and not experience the ride the same way it did. There's more to add on to that. But really, you could do things from the same way that I talked about the leash, is you could load the dog into the car, wait until they're calm, take them back out, never take them to the fun, happy place that they want to go to. Don't let the, if something's predicting excitement and you don't like the excitement that the, you know, what behavior's coming out of that excitement, then you have to get rid of that initial excitement. You have to get rid of that the car ride is not fun. Or you can even shift it. The car ride means I go in and I eat food, which means now maybe you could practice obedience while the dog's in the car, which will eventually lead you to being able to tell the dog to maybe quiet down. Start with a couple of those things. See how you like it. Throw questions, comments. We'll talk to you later.